How to manage a chronic case. As we are aware that homeopathy is well known for its ability to manage chronic cases. Today we shall discuss on how to manage such chronic cases. Now let's first try to understand as to what a chronic disease is and how it differs from an acute one. Chronic diseases are those which have an insidious onset. They tend to progress gradually, and unlike acute diseases, they do not have a definite course and shall never end in recovery of its own. Now, from the above definition, it becomes very evident that successfully handling a chronic case is more challenging for any homeopath than managing any acute case. Here, let's give you an overview on how to handle such chronic cases so that you get the expected result in each and every case. Clinically, a chronic case can present with an acute exacerbation. In such cases, if we expect the patient to give us a detailed case history before selecting a remedy, he may never turn back to you in future. Ideally, in such cases, the approach should be to bring down the acute attack first, and then, once it has subsided, the patient has to be called up again for a detailed case taking. The criteria to select a remedy for such acute exacerbation shall remain the same as we had discussed earlier. Let's show you clinically how this can be done and how you can convince the patient to turn back again for a detailed case taking.
अच्छा, आपने अभी अभी मुझे बताया कि आपको ये तकलीफ पिछले 6 सालों से है ना?
जी।
आपको सिर्फ अभी के लिए आराम चाहिए या आप ये चाहते हैं कि मैं आपकी बीमारी को पूरी तरह से निकाल दूं आपके शरीर से?
क्या ऐसा हो सकता है?
जी बिल्कुल हो सकता है, पर उसके लिए आपको हमें वक्त देना होगा।
मुझे क्या करना होगा डॉक्टर?
हमें आपकी पूरी बीमारी को पहले समझना होगा कि इन 6 सालों में यह बीमारी कहां तक बढ़ चुकी है। इसके लिए आपका केस हमको डिटेल में लेना होगा, जिसके लिए कम से कम 1 घंटा लगेगा।
किसी तरह छुटकारा मिल सकता है तो सर, 1 घंटा क्या, जितना टाइम आप बोलेंगे उतना टाइम देने के लिए तैयार हूं।
पहले आपका पूरा केस समझेंगे, उसके बाद ही हम आपको कोई ऐसी दवा दे सकते हैं जो आपकी बीमारी को पूरी तरह से बाहर निकाल दे। ठीक है, तो आप एक काम कीजिए, कल परसों या जब भी आपके पास समय हो उस टाइम का आप एक स्पेशल अपॉइंटमेंट ले लीजिए, ताकि मैं उस समय अपने आप को सिर्फ आपके लिए फ्री रख सकूं। और हां, आप अपनी सारी रिपोर्ट्स लेकर आइएगा। हां, अब तक आपने जो बातें यहां बताई हैं उनको पूरी तरह से फिर से हमें पढ़ना पड़ेगा और 2-3 घंटे इस पर काम करना पड़ेगा, तब जाकर आपकी सही दवा हम डिसाइड कर पाएंगे। अब जब हम आपके एक केस पर 3-4 घंटे मेहनत कर रहे हैं, तो आपको भी कम से कम 4-5 महीने हमारा साथ देना होगा। अगर आपने बीच में दवा बंद कर दी तो फिर आप इधर मत आइएगा, दोबारा घूमते रहिएगा जिंदगी भर।
नहीं डॉक्टर, मैं रेगुलर लूंगा मेडिसिंस, बस किसी तरह से ये निकल जाए, मैं पूरी तरह से ठीक हो जाऊं बस।
Refers to the condition where a chronic case is presented with no prominent symptoms to be seen at the time of consultation, but the same has to be traced by a detailed case taking. Refers to a condition where the patient is suffering continuously for a long period of time with prominent symptoms. Now, the process of managing a chronic case can be divided into 3 stages: case taking, case analysis and evaluation, repertorization. In our upcoming videos, we shall discuss in details each of these steps. Here, let's run through an overview of the entire procedure. Case taking is a process of collecting the required information from the patient that it can be worked out to guide us select the perfect simillimum for that given case. It's said that a well-taken case is as good as half-cured. There are multiple reasons as to why such a statement is made. We shall be posting a separate video on discussing as why it is said that a well-taken case is half-cured. Now, once we have completed the case-taking part, we should have enough information and symptoms to work with. The next step is to classify the observed symptoms. The classification of the symptoms shall be explained in detail in our upcoming video. However, it has to be remembered that the symptoms that we get after a detailed case taking can be broadly divided into 2 groups: symptoms of the disease, Symptoms of the patient. Symptoms of the disease are usually the common symptoms which guide us to make a correct diagnosis. But from the point of view of selecting a homeopathic remedy, it's the symptoms of the patient that deserves to get more importance. Now, this symptoms of the patient can further be divided into two. That is, symptoms belonging to his normal disposition and symptoms belonging to his changed disposition. Each of these has to be given based on its value. The topic giving value to the symptoms shall also be covered in our upcoming video. Once we have done with classifying the symptoms and giving value to it, the next step is to rearrange the observed symptoms in descending order of their value. That is, the symptoms having highest value are placed at the top and those having least value at the bottom. This procedure helps us to form the totality of the case. Now, once such a totality is constructed, then comes the most important task of selecting the eliminating symptom. This selection has to be made with precision, because if you make a mistake in selecting the eliminating symptom, our perfect similimum may get ruled out in the very beginning during repertorization. We shall explain you in detail as to what an eliminating symptom is and how it has to be selected in our upcoming video. Once the totality is constructed, it completes the second step, and then we need to convert the symptoms forming our totality into its appropriate rubrics, which gives us the repertorial totality. Then the case has to be repertorized. At the end of repertorization, the repertorial result gives us a final list of 3 or 4 remedies to choose from for the final selection of remedy. The remedy that fits the most into the totality has to be then selected by referring the materia medica.